Today we will be playing this. This is SpongeBob SuperSponge for the PlayStation 1. This game is one of the first games I can remember playing. This game's from 2002. I would have been 3 years old. And I literally do not remember existing without this game. I recently just reordered it. I ordered the Greatest Hits version because that's what I had when I was a kid. This game is actually what the aesthetic of this stream is based on. Like this pineapple image you guys see here for the chat box. That's based on one of the loading screens from this game, which I know you guys will see because I just played through a few levels of this a minute ago, which I'm going to restart, of course. But this is a fun game. And of course, on the PS2, we've got the classic blue controller that you can kind of see through here. I feel like this is a pretty nice controller. So let's switch over to the live screen. If you guys can't hear anything, please let me know, because I don't want to get 20 minutes into the stream and not be able to hear anything. So, also, if my PS2 makes weird random sounds, I apologize. The PS2 that I am using is the one that I've had since I was a kid. So, it's kind of old, ran down, the DVD player does not work anymore. So, yeah. See what we get. There it is. I know that it works. I tested it before I even streamed. Did I not put the game back in? Nope, I'm a dumbass. No. Here is the game. Sony Computer Entertainment. And then we wait. There it is. The old PlayStation logo. Did you guys hear the PlayStation logo? I'm checking Twitch on my phone. THQ. Well, I know you guys can hear me because I just heard my voice. If you guys are wondering why I'm asking, it's because I literally just did this stream. You guys probably couldn't hear me. Anyway, the music in this game is so nostalgic for me. Audio is good. Thank you, sir. I appreciate it. Start game. Game is loud. Yes, I know. I turned it down. If the game ends up being too loud, just let me know. But I did turn it down. If it's still too loud, I'll fix it.
Ah, here we are at Bikini Bottom. And today, we will be following my favorite creature, SpongeBob. Today, he is in search of the best.
And look at them graphics. I remember this game
Gary,
looking a lot better when I was little.
I just had a great idea about what to get Patrick for his birthday.
Oh no, not you again. Just keep the noise down.
Remember
what do you want?
Yes, we do start in Jellyfish Fields.
It's my best friend Patrick's
birthday.
Like
I said, I just played the whole first level without audio.
So
now we're gonna do it again.
Well, we are a bit busy right now. No rest for superheroes. Well, I know
that
my
main man
might consider signing one for a superhero snack.
One, two, there's five of them.
Sea nut butter.
Sea nut butter.
Like a calculator, you can count on it.
I like how Barnacle Boy has a little nose wipe. Now loading. Obviously, that is not the loading screen that I based my aesthetic on. There it is! There it is, guys! That is my background. Obviously, I had my friend redraw it because I didn't want to get copywritten, but that's what it's based on. Oh, look at the 3D on that bus. Oh, look, there's Squidward. There's my boy.
Hi, Squidward.
Hi,
ready
Squidward.
For another great...
Today's Sunday Spine.
Hey, I can use this.
For those of you guys who don't know, these spatulas are kind of like Sonic's rings. You need them. Not that noise. What noise? Like his feet? The zero button spatula. Like, oh yeah, you're gonna probably hear that a lot. I am not good at this game. Ah, fucker! Come here. No, okay. It's kind of funny, I said in the last stream, which nobody could hear, that when I was a kid, I used to play the first level, get to the final boss, get stuck, and then just restart and play the first level again. Well, this time I got to the first boss, beat the first boss, but now I'm restarting at the beginning again because my stream was fucked up. That's the end of the first level, guys. That's the end. That's the easiest level in the whole fucking game. Yeah, chapter one, not level one. This is chapter one right there. I like how I point to the screen, like you guys can see my screen.
SpongeBob, you silly old
And here's the level where SpongeBob does not wear his helmet. It is instead this little bar on the edge, and you have to jump into these vats of water. The music is nothing like the music in the show. It always felt strange to you. I guess. See, it feels like SpongeBob to me. But you gotta remember, this game came out when I was 3, and it's literally the first video game I ever played, so I just kind of have always associated this with SpongeBob. So when I hear the music, it just gives me a good vibe. If I could take the music from this game and use it in my streams, I would. Like at the beginning, instead of playing that generic copyright-free music, I would play the music from this game, but I'm afraid I would get copyright infringement, like, out the ass. I mean, I already designed my graphics based on this game. I'm only gonna make that weird face. Come on, SpongeBob, make the weird face. Oh, screw it. He makes this really weird face when he's, like, standing on the edge of stuff. No, 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 no. There it is! There's the weird face! But now I've fallen. I've fallen and I cannot get up. Ouch! I extra life. Cool. And now I have to go down. I just remember you go all the way up the tree just to go inside of the tree, and then go all the way down. I don't know why that's the way it works, but that's the way it works. Alright. Might as well get in this water. And go all the way down. Alright, now we gotta go to the fish hooks level. My girlfriend, she just got her driver's license and she just drove for the first time by herself and she's Snapchatting me about it. She's very nervous. Oh, so I started singing to it. There it is. I remembered the music in this game like instantly when I started playing it a minute ago. I'm probably gonna start reordering games from my childhood and playing them on stream. Now that I can stream AV. Get consoles because I still have my PS2 here, which can play PS1. I have my Wii, which can play GameCube, and then I have my Super Nintendo, which can play like original Game Boy as well, like the Game Boy, the Super Game Boy, I think that's what it's called. So this capture card has really opened up my ability to play games. Because I really, before, was limited to emulators or whatever I could get on PC. But now that I have this capture card, I got the Elgato HD 60S Plus. It can, you know, it can output 480-60, which is nice. Not 480, 1080-60. 480-60, Jesus Christ. I would hope it could output a 480-60, Jesus. If I recall, this is the end of the game right here. No. Did I beat the level? I think so. When I played it a minute ago, I died right there. Was this even 480? It's being upscaled to 1080 with that adapter right now, but I do not know what the resolution quality was on PS1. I have no idea. I don't know why I just tried to look at the box to see if it was on there. I was like, it'll be on here. Fuck off, crab. Creature things? There's the pit to hell. Okay. Avoid the pit to hell. Ouch! I like how that SpongeBob's only death sound. Ouch! 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 No, fuck! I went into the portal to hell. No. Motherfucker. Ouch. Ah, no, fuck! I'm gonna lose all my lives before I even get to the boss. Fuck! I fell into the hole again. I keep wanting to double jump. But double jump in this game is this. So I'm used to being able to double jump for a bigger jump, but instead it makes SpongeBob go down. So I go to fall into a hole, my natural reaction is to spam the X button, which just makes me fall into the hole faster. Which is not what I want to happen. Oh, thank God. Checkpoint. Okay, cool. Come on. Fuck yeah. Okay. We're at the boss. Mother Jellyfish. I remember how I did this a minute ago. I have to get to my comfort mailbox. There it is. There's my comfort mailbox. Okay. So what we do is we stand here. We catch all the jellyfish. And then we just kind of wait. Where's that? Oh, I hit it. I hit it, I think. And then he's special, then he's specialist. Sorry, I'm trying to focus. Alright, I got two hits in. Fuck, I went to hit the... I keep getting the capture and the attack button confused. To capture is circle, to attack is square, and I keep doing it the other way. Apparently there was also a Game Boy Advance port of this game. Imagine what it would be like. Look at all of that face he makes. I know. You bastard. Dang it. I keep not dodging his attacks. I'm really special. No! Bastard! You bastard. Reminds you of the Game Boy version of Breaking the Rules. That's actually the game I was looking for, Break Into Rules, when I ordered that one PC game. But that other PC game popped up and it was only like $5, so I had to buy it. I hit it. Okay. Fuck. Eat the bread. Okay. Ta-da. That was complicated. Oh my god. This is about the point in the last one when I realized I wasn't streaming audio, so...
I'm ready.
Oops, and then it does the worst back already. Throw animation that is I've ever
definitely
seen.
A sandwich fit for a superhero.
I'm on my way.
On the way. I don't know what this is from.